Let's walk the Lebanon outlets in Tennessee. The outlet mall features work that has been done by local artists in Middle Tennessee. This is Gap Outlet. It has clothing and fashion accessories. Not be showing inside open active stores out of courtesy to the employees and shoppers inside them. Here you can see the Loft Outlet label scar on the building. Please keep in mind I am still learning the stabilization rig. Let's take a look. Store no more. Now that is sad. There's plenty of it here. Are you noticing any signs above? This wing, aside from Gap and a few other retailers, is pretty much dead. Founded in 1818 in New York City, Brooks Brothers, the oldest retailer in the country, even they couldn't make it here. Off in the distance, you can see Interstate 40, a coast-to-coast busy highway that spans from North Carolina to California. Location is not this outlet mall's problem. This reminds me of Richland Mall before AMC left. This is only the beginning. Five retailers occupy this whole wing, along with this Christian International Transformation Place. Here's Famous Footwear. Yeah, I probably could use a pair. Thank you. Walking through this area was quite sad, knowing that this place is dying. Neglect has started to show. Had this place been maintained, that would not be acceptable. Kind of reminds me of West Tennessee, flatlands. Reminds me of home. There are more employee cars in here than customer cars out in the main lot. Well, I think we found out where they put the stores. Anyone who's gone to a mall can smell this place from the moment they get into the building. They're still taking applications. we'll take a look at the factory store. Churches tend to be attracted to dying malls. There is tons of parking. The place is set up for lots of parking, and that is actually one thing that churches struggle with, is parking for their congregation members. Also, the space is very modular, meaning that as the congregation grows and expands, they add services and different things. They can also expand by tearing down the wall next to the business, leasing out that space, decorating it, and you got instant space on the cheap. It also helps the building owner with stopgap income. You can see some more neglect here. You got a beam that's starting to weather pretty bad. Remember what I said about the parking? Do they have plenty of it? Absolutely. This mall, unfortunately, is a victim of e-commerce. As beautiful as it is, more than likely, it will never be back to its former self. Simon Properties page to lease, this is where they took that photograph of the people coming out of that store. That store is no longer there.